Master Goo asks, how do you make the best goo? Well, Master Goo, I'm no master in goo, but I think we can help you out a bit. First, let's talk about what goo is. Goo, also called slime, is what's called a non-Newtonian fluid. It was first studied by Sir Isaac Newton, you know, the guy that had apples fall on his head and such. He found that not all liquids pour easily. For example, water pours quickly from a cup, but syrup, or that stubborn ketchup, pours more slowly. Viscosity is a word that we use to describe how slow something pours. And it also sounds like a fancy word that should be used at tea parties. Henrietta, the viscosity of this tea is quite superfluous. Slime is interesting because the more you squeeze it, the more viscous, think stiffer, it becomes. This is because slime is made from really long molecules.
For comparison, here's a simple water molecule, where each circle is an atom that's bonded together to form the molecule. Many slimes are made from glue, so let's look at a glue molecule. You'll notice how different in size the two molecules are. Now, glue molecules look a lot like a strand of Christmas lights, actually, and Christmas lights are actually a great analogy to understand what is really happening with slime.
Every year, the hardest part of putting up Christmas lights is untangling that box of lights. It happens every year because we squish the lights together in a small box in the hopes that next year, someone else will be in charge of untangling them. It's the same with long molecules in slime. When you push on them, they get all tangled together and don't pour out of the box. All that tangling makes the slime become more viscous. The molecules get in each other's way and it stiffens up. When making slime, there are two common ingredients, glue and borax, or really boric acid. Glue already pours pretty slowly because it is made from a bunch of long molecules that get tangled together. But when borax, water, and glue are combined, the borax molecules, or the boric acid molecules, tie the long glue molecules together, like as if I were to, for some reason, tie different light strands together. This makes the tangling even worse and makes it even stiffer, and yeah, we're not putting up Christmas lights this year. So with that science out of the way, it's time to really answer your question, what makes the best goo? Well, it depends on what you consider to be the best. There are a lot of different kinds of slime, from glow-in-the-dark to bubble wrap slime. Goo or slime is made from the same basic ingredients, but you don't have to use glue. Remember, glue is good because it is made from long molecules, but most anything with long molecules could be made into slime, like cornstarch or gelatin or psyllium husk. Psyllium husk, that's fun to say. Psyllium husk. So I sat down and try to make some different slimes to compare because of science, but I failed. I'm no good at making slime, so I guess the answer is you can make the best goo by not letting me make it for you. There we go. So keep being viscous, keep asking questions, and keep on squinting. Have a question you want answered? Okay, well then leave it in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more Invisible Science.
Where did I go? I'm invisible.